Hello friends, I am back again with my Ashtakwarga video part 2. In the first video of this Ashtakwarga charts, I had told about the usage of these charts and what are the areas where they can be used and little bit about how to use these charts. I feel that there are certain more points that needed to be told, so I thought of making this another video in which I'll be covering up some more topics on Ashtakwarga about the usage. So to begin with, first of all, let's take the Sarva Ashtakwarga chart, that is the sum total of all the beneficial points that the planets are giving to a house to see the strength of that particular house. So any house which is having 28 points or more is deemed as a strong house. So it is not advisable, or I would say it is not good to have larger number of points in the 6th, 8th and 12th houses, because these are the trick houses, and if the trick houses are strong, then the difficulties or upheavals or expenses would also trigger up. They would also be high in a person's life. So these houses should be having lesser number of points, as less as possible. So let's talk about how to evaluate a house's strength by seeing the Sarva Ashtakwarga chart. So the first house, if it is having 28 points or more than that, larger the points, better the personality a person is having, and larger the points, the person will have a good reputation in his life. The person will have a good physique also. He'll be very impactful on the other person whomsoever he'll meet because of the large points in the first house. If your second house is having good number of points, it means that you will have a lot of wealth. You will be a good orator. You will be having a very impactful speech and a good family life. If the third house is having good number of points, it means the person is very strong and the person could also manipulate things. He could lie sometimes. So that is one of the traits of the third house having larger number of points. So the fourth house, if it is having more points, shows that the person will get lots of happiness in his life. There is going to be lots of domesticated things happening in this person's life. If the fifth house has more points, the person is very, very creative and very intelligent. If the sixth house is having more points, it shows that the person will be disease free. The person will not have any court cases or difficulties. So it is good to have lesser points in the sixth house. And the sixth house should always have less points compared to the first house, that is your lagna. Now the seventh house, if it is strong, if it is having more points, then business suits you and you will have the happiness of your spouse. And if the seventh house is having more points compared to the fifth house, then it means that your spouse would be very, very strong compared to you. If the fifth house is having more points than the seventh house, then it means that you will dominate your spouse. So these two houses should be seen to evaluate this particular thing. If the eighth house is having larger number of points, it shows that the person will be having bad health and the person would not be having a long life. So, and he would be prone to accidents. So it is not good to have more points in the 8th house. If the 9th house is having larger number of points, then the person's conduct in life is very good. He is very righteous. He performs good deeds. And he is quite lucky also. If the 10th house is having good number of points, then the person will get a lot of honor in his life. He will have a good status also. And he will work really very hard. If the 11th house is having more points than the 10th house, it means the work is less compared to the gains. The gains are more. Whereas if the 11th house is having lesser points than the 10th house, it means the person works more but the gains are less. Also, the 10th house having more points can mean the person is suitable for independent work. And in the 6th house, if the points are huge, it means the person is good for service industry. He is not suitable for independent work. If the 12th house is having more points, the person will be able to save less. The person would be a spendthrift. Also, it can mean the person can prosper outside his country of birth because 12th house is also abroad. So this way you can see the Sarvashtakvarga chart. So if you divide your life into four parts, then the first part would be from the 12th house to your 3rd house, that is the Pisces, Aries, Taurus and Gemini. This will be your first part of life, so which means this will be your youth. So add the number of points of these four houses, and after that add the number of points from 4th house to your 7th house, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th. So add the points of these four houses and then add the points of 8th, 9th, 10th and 11th. So these four houses. So the first group is your youth, that is your childhood period. So how you lived your childhood would be seen from the first grouping, that is from the Pisces to the Gemini. Then the second part of your life, that is your youth part, would be from the 4th to the 7th house. See the number of points that you are having. Then the points from the 8th house to your 11th house is your old age or later age in life. So the points which are highest would give you a fair idea that what part of your life would be better than the other parts of your life. If all the three groups are having equal number of points, it means that your life would be by and large in the same trend. But if one part of your grouping is having higher points, shows that in one part of your life you will do much better as compared to the other parts of your life. Then if you want to see a favorable direction for yourself, in that case you should count the points from the first house till your 11th house. This will be the east direction, because we all know that when the birth take place, the sign falling in the eastern horizon is your lagna. So it means from the lagna to the 11th house would be the east direction. Add the number of Sarvashtakvarga points in these three houses, and then from the 10th house, 9th house and 8th house comes the south direction. Add the number of points of these three houses and keep them aside. Then the points from the 7th, 6th and 5th house, these three houses would give you the direction of the west. Add these points, and then the points of the 4th house, 3rd house and the 2nd house, this will give you the direction of the north. So out of all the three totals, see which total is having the highest points. The total which is having the highest point would give you an idea that that particular direction for you would be favorable compared to the other directions. So if you do your work in those directions, you will always find good energies or favorable results. So that is one more funda of using the Ashtakwarga charts. Then is that if you want to see what age you will be successful in life, for that you can consider the lagna as your first year of life, and the second house could be your second year, third house third year. Likewise, you complete one rotation, the 12th house becomes your 12th year, then again the lagna becomes your 13th year, and then the 12th year 12th house becomes your 24th year. So likewise, you just go on rotating and keep on adding the ages. So whatever house is getting highest points would be the age when you will do the best in your life at that particular age. So this thing can also be judged by the use of Ashtakwarga charts. Then is, if you want to see the marital happiness between two people, between a husband and a wife, or between a boy and girl who is seeking a marriage alliance, you need to see the points where their moon signs are placed. See the points of Sarvashtakvarg in the moon sign of boy and in the moon sign of girl. So if these two houses are having 30 points or more than 30 points, it will mean that they will both live a very happy and cordial life. So this is one more area of Ashtakwarg that can be seen. And then one more point that can be used for the Ashtakwarga calculation or interpretation is that the sign which is having the least point in your Ashtakwarga chart, if that sign is rising as a lagna during a particular day, you should go for treatment of your ailments on that day. Then you will be able to get a permanent cure if you go on that day when the lowest points are rising as lagna on a particular day. Another thing is that if you count the total of your second house, ninth house, 10th house, 11th house and 4th house, if you count the total of these four houses and the total comes out to be 164 or more, then it means you will get lots of happiness from the income that you will have. But if the points of 6th house, 8th house and 12th house are having 76 points or more, then there would be lots of expenses that you will have to incur in your life. So you can easily do the calculation of these houses and judge what kind of happiness would you be having in these houses, related to these houses. Then there is one more thing. If you do the total of your first house, fifth house and ninth house, these are the trinal houses of your karmas, of your actions. So it means that you are suitable for independent work, and it also means that you are a very passionate person. And if the second house, sixth house and the 10th house are having more points, it means that you will have sufficient amount of wealth and people related happiness, or you can say that you are a practical person. If the 3rd house, 7th house and the 11th house, their total is more than the other totals, then you can say that you are an intellectual person, you think more than you act, and you will be having lots of gains in your life. If the 4th house, 8th house and the 12th house total is more than all other totals, it means that you are a person who is very emotional and who could be very spiritual also in his approach. So friends, these are some of the areas where Ashtakwarga can be used very appropriately. There is one more point before winding up I would like to tell you, is that while you open the Sarvashtakvarga chart of a planet, and if any house is having 0 points during the dasha of that planet's Ashtakwarga chart or Bhin Ashtakwarga chart, the house which is having 0 points and any planet, if it is placed in that house, if the dasha of that planet comes, that house will be giving you very, very bad results. In fact, there could be decline of that house. That house can totally be eradicated. So let me explain to you this example, this with an example. Suppose you open up the Sarvashtakvarga chart of Saturn. See, generally Saturn will not give a point where it is sitting. So Saturn and Mars, these are two planets that generally give 0 points in their Bhin Ashtakvarga charts. So you open up the Sarvashtakvarga chart of Saturn, and if there is a particular house which is having 0 points, and suppose there is Jupiter sitting in that house, so during the dasha and antar of Saturn and Jupiter, the house which is having 0 points would undergo lots of sufferings. So this is one more very, very important point that need not be ignored. So friends, this was all about the Ashtakwarga charts and their uses. I'll see you next time with something else which is of great use to you. See you friends, until then, bye.